to the north border region of the border rail manager. And in the centre we put a panel, made it white. We added a text field and we added a sidebar to it. But what we're going to do now is we're going to add pictures, images to the buttons. That's how you see a toolbar. This is a toolbar. It's not got names on it. It is all buttons, but they have pictures on it. So what I've done, I've added icons to the software. Right. And so what we're going to do is we're going to add, what we've got to do is make an instance of image icon public, and we're going to make it global. Static because we're going to use it in main. We'll give it a name, icon, because I don't know anything better to call it. We can go to icon and it's image icon. That's the type. Just like you've got J menu, you've got J button, J slider, J text field, and image icon. And we're going to call it T icon. T icon. I don't like that, just icon. So that's us declared a global variable of type image icon. And so inside main, we can go down to after we've created the toolbar, is it here? And so we called the icon equals new image. This is going to be the constructor of the image icon class that we created the object of. And what we're going to pass in here is the path to the image and the name of the image file. And what we're going to use, we're going to use this one here for the moment because it's only a small name. We'll use a paint icon. So it's a string, the path gets put into a string, and the path here is from a source file. The project is tutorial, so it's inside the source file in the project and then that file name. So what we do is we do it. So source, Windows way of doing it is that way, and the Unix way is that way. You can do whatever way you want, both will work. I'll do it in this way just so you can see it. And the name of the file was, the file was paint. Paint icon. Paint icon dot png. And so that's us giving the path. And what we need to do now is we've made that instance and instance of image icon and passed a picture to it, an image to it. Now we need to add that to a button, and the easiest way to do it is, see how we have the name of the toolbar here and a string? Well, if we take that away and just replace that with the name of the icon and its icon, and save the program, then that will change the button of, instead of having a name, it'll have it will have an icon. And so and there you go, that's a paint icon. If I click it, you'll see it's printed Charles. So if we put a smaller picture in there, then it would have been a smaller icon. And so we're going to go deeper into images. Right, so you can make them small, you can make them big, you can do all different sorts of things with them. And so we'll go deep into it at the moment and just showing you that we can change all these to icons. Now, that's the size of that icon. So the buttons took the default size of the image. So if this one was a small one, this would be a smaller button. So the ideal way would be half all the images the same size that you use. And obviously, if you're going to design a software package, you're going to give yourself the time to do that because you want it to look good. So what I'm going to do is add images to the other buttons so you can see it. And so if I take this away, I'm going to pause and do it, save a little bit of time. So what I've done is cut and paste icon one, it's the icon to icon one, cut and paste it. They've all got the same picture inside them, and cut and paste the image icon one. So I've done it 7 times, and then I went down to the buttons and changed all the buttons to icon 2, icon 3, right down to 7. And so if we're on the program, it'll all be the same picture. And you can see all the same all buttons. I've not added an action listener to these. I've just added an action listener to the first one. But we would add an action listener to all the toolbar images. And each one would be a different picture. So we're going to change the picture. And I'm going to pause again, save for a little bit of time. Right, so I've changed all the images for the icons. They'll all be in the same picture, they'll be different images. And you can see this, they're all different sizes. If they're all the same size, it'll look good, but you don't want them different sizes. And obviously these pictures would be an image that would suit the job it's going to do. Let's see if I can get this one. And if I can get this one too. Yeah. And we can take it outside. And we can use it that way as well. If I move this away, you can see. No, I've not attached any of these to an action listener. So they don't do anything, but you can use them just the same. So that's images, and that's the easiest way to do it, is to add the image to the button. You can also do it this way here, and the name of the button JB17. Set. Not too sure. You can do it this way anyway, just try it. Come on. Yeah, I'm not too sure. Right, but that's the easiest way to do it anyway, is the way I showed you. And so again, thank you for your time. I hope this has not been too long. I've tried to cut down the time with pausing the video. So again, thank you. And if that's helped at least one person, and you're that one person, then I've done my job, because that's what this is all about. It's the person that gets helped. Somebody that's looking for help in something, if they come across something that helps them, that's what it's all about. The most stuff that goes on these places at YouTube and things like that, the better. Right, thank you.